All right, ladies and gentlemen, I know y'all think I'm going to cry and complain about this game, but no, this is one of the reasons why this game can never be considered competitive. I'm going to let you watch what happens here, and then we're going to play it back. Okay, we did that. Did you see what happened there? You're going to see in a second. I hope you see. Why are they taking the ball out? Why is it their ball? Because a timeout was called, and you probably thought that. Let me just show right here. Let me say. When you saw this right here, timeout by Snubs. You probably thought Snubs was on our team. Snubs is not on our team. Snubs is on the other team. How is this man able to call a timeout? The rules of basketball state that you must have possession of the ball and be on the court, you know, have possession on the ball on the court before you can call a timeout. What Charles Barkley used to do is get the ball, jump out of bounds sometimes and call a 20-second timeout to retain possession. You can't do that anymore. If you're already out of bounds, you can't call a timeout. So you must have possession of the ball on the floor in order to call a timeout. Right here, this man dribbles. That's Snubs right there. Snubs the one that lost the ball. Snubs loses the ball, gets it back. Loses it again. First off, okay, they actually let his leg be physics right here. They actually let him dribble, because that never happens. We know that never happens. When you dribble into somebody's leg, you never lose the ball, right? So they actually let physics prevail, and he lost the ball. Right here, who touches the ball? The computer touches the ball. But he does not have possession. There is no possession. There is no possession. There is no possession. There is no. So right here, he has not called timeout now. Look, nobody has possession now. The timeout still has not been called. Nobody has possession. Right here. Hold up. It is not until right here, our man gets possession of the ball. And they allow Snubs to call timeout. Why? Let me go back there. Do y'all understand how broken that is? How completely stupid that is? Do you get why this game is so trash? I want to see somebody in the comments rationalize this one. Because it does not matter what I put up. It does not matter what I put up about this game. Somebody always finds a way to rationalize it. Well, it's a two. Pure Sharks got 99. They should not have 99 contested shots, is what we're saying. Players in the NBA, they hit contested shots all the time. They've been practicing since they were 5 years old to perfect a craft. You don't. Whatever. I want somebody to rationalize this. Please. Please rationalize this. I don't even care about all that. Please, please rationalize how he was able to call a timeout. I am showing you. If he called timeout right here, I couldn't have argued, right? I couldn't have argued. Now nobody has possession. He shouldn't even have the ability.
Right!
So, let's go back. If he called it right here, I'd have been like, okay, whatever. Right here, I might have been like, okay, whatever. Okay, now, the computer is not touching the ball anymore. It is not until our man gains possession of the basketball, then they let him call a timeout. When we have possession of the basketball. So all this time, right here, he's probably spamming timeout this whole time. But nobody has possession. Why is he given? Look, that's possession right there. Possession. Okay, so when you see the ball draw toward my dog's hand, that's possession. That counts as possession because the ball is magnetized to his hand at that point. So now he has the ball. We have possession of the ball, and they give Snubs the timeout. I just want to see what someone is going to say to defend this. You cannot call timeout when the other team has possession. You can't do it. Unless it's a dead ball situation, they get ready to inbound the ball. I don't even know if you can do it. You cannot call a timeout when the other team has possession, and even if you could, why is it their ball? We had possession. What is going on, 2K? I gotta show y'all this one. Excuse me. Now, we beating the brakes off these dudes and that. Like, 2K literally is having pity on people. This dude is this bad. He tries to dribble. Like, I don't get it. We act, like I said, they actually let us have some physics there. Like I said, if they let him call timeout right there, I'd have been like, eh, okay. Or right here. Because technically the computer has the ball, right? But here, there is no possession. There's no possession. This is a free ball. You can't call timeout. Especially when the other team has possession. What is this game? Like, really? What is this game? What is this, what we do? Like, he literally is spamming timeout. And when we get possession, I don't know, man. This game is trash. This is definitive proof that the game is trash. Like, if that happened in real life, it would almost be excusable. Do you know why? It would almost be excusable if it happened in real life. It would almost be excusable if it happened in real life because there's human error and they might have said, well, he had possession right here. This is a video game. It is literally coded to where you cannot call a timeout when the other team has possession. You can't do it. It should be coded that way. It should be hard coded. This is a universe where things like this should not have the ability to happen. I can call the timeout in real life and be like, ref, timeout. And you might get a ref that don't know the rules that might call that timeout and grant me the timeout. But under no circumstances will we get the ball. Somebody might make a mistake, but we wouldn't. But this is a video game. This should be hard-coded. Nobody has the ball. We get it. They give him the timeout. Why is Snubs not fouling somebody right here? Why is he not fouling somebody since we got the ball? It doesn't make sense, man. This is stupid. Ball is magnetized to his hand at this point. You know he's going to get it. And they give them the timeout. And possession of the basketball. Right. As long as things like that have the ability to happen, this game cannot be called competitive. You can't call it competitive. You can't call it a good game. Nobody can call it a good game after seeing this. This cannot happen. What if the Jukebockers is playing Dimes? Maybe Dimes play for the Jukebockers. I don't know. What if the Island Gang is playing Dimes and that happens at the end of the game and they lose off of that in the tournament? Because if it can happen here, it can happen in the tournament, right? So what if this happens and they lose off of that? They get an extra possession because somebody spammed the button and they were awarded a timeout. Then what are we going to do? What do you do when there's a glaring hole in your game? Then there's several glaring holes. We're not even going to get to that. But when something like this can happen, and it's like what do we do? What do you do when something like that can happen? What was he getting ready to do? Let's see. Look, not only did he get possession of the ball, look, he getting ready to dribble down court and dunk some. Look. He's literally getting ready. He dribbled. So he didn't lose the ball or anything. He clearly has possession. He's getting ready to dribble down the court and dunk some. And they're like, nah, player. Not only are we going to give him the timeout, but it ain't your ball either. Like I said, dog, I know y'all love these transitions. They kind of whack, but it is what it is. I just don't understand how things like that are allowed to happen. It shouldn't be allowed to happen. I don't know why it is allowed to happen. But, hey. It is what it is, man. Y'all let me know in the comments what you guys think, man. I just don't know. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to tell you. This game is awful. And this is the proof, the irrefutable evidence beyond the shadow of a doubt that this game is trash. Luckily, we was dogging these dudes, and it didn't matter. We beat them by like 100 or something, and it didn't matter. But what if it did matter? What if this was the game on the line and something like that happens? Just knowing that something like that has the potential to happen bothers me. Anyway, man, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'm going to holler at y'all next time. Do what you got to do. Tell me what you think. Let's see if some, I really want to see what type of idiot tries to rationalize that. You can't call timeout during periods of simultaneous possession, nor can you call timeout during periods of no possession. Someone has to possess the basketball, and you can, and you cannot call timeout during gameplay of the other team, right? Because if you could, you know, while the ball is in play, you can only call timeouts on a dead ball or when you have possession of the basketball. There are no other circumstances under which you can call timeout. So the only person that should have been able to call timeout, and look, like I said, right, man right here, we have the ball. He's getting ready to dribble and dunk some. That should not be able to happen. The fact that it does happen just proves that the game is trash. Anybody defending this game after this, something is seriously wrong with you, because this is irrefutable evidence that this game is trash. And they need to take it back to the drawing board. But anyway, we're going to keep on playing it because we ain't got nothing else to play. And we got Throwback Thursday coming up tonight, man. We're going to be playing some 2K17 on the Xbox tonight, man. So if you got Xbox, come on through. We're going to play some 2K17 and see how that goes, man. Because this game, it ain't no hope for this game. This game trash. I'm out of here. Till next time. It's your boy, Jay Eazy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Holla! 360 out this mug. This game is trash, and nobody can tell me different. This is what it is.